British people are fed up. They're fed up with us not delivering. They're fed up with unfulfilled promises. And they're fed up with divisive politics. So how do we turn this around? Well, first of all, we have to admit that Whitehall is broken. There are great people that work there. But in my administration, you will see it look and feel very different very fast. We need to do some serious machinery of government changes. We're going to have a tighter cabinet. We're going to have ministers of state that have clear and timely deliverables and are powerful and can reach across Whitehall. And we're going to modernise government with the white heat of modernisation. We need to move at the speed that business and science needs us to. Secondly, we need to build a modern economy. Now, you'll have heard pitches this week on tax and spend. I'm going to talk about growth and competition. My key fiscal rule is that debt as a percentage of GDP will fall over time. My monetary policy will be on controlling inflation, and our supply side reforms will yield a Brexit dividend on investment, infrastructure, incentives, and innovation. And we also need to let our citizens live well. From me, you're going to get a relentless focus on cost of living issues. I've already announced that on day one, we are going to slash VAT on fuel at the pump by half. And we are going to raise income tax thresholds for basic and middle income earners in line with inflation. But we also need to extract more value. For example, through simplifying and reducing the cost of being tax compliant for our citizens and for business. And we need to get things to work better. I'm going to be putting power back into the hands of parents. We are going to create personal budgets to allow every child access to their entitlements to subsidised childcare at any time prior to them starting full-time school. And we are going to create some task forces to get a grip on the crisis and paralysis in accessing NHS services and dentists. And also, and vitally, stagnation in house building. Fourthly, if we are really serious about levelling up, we cannot be limited in our ambition by what is in the Treasury's coffers. We have to get real about this. So I want to align government planning cycles with those of business and the charity sector, which are already aligned. And that will give us huge opportunities to co-fund, to form partnerships, to do more for our citizens. And we need some national missions in this country that the whole country and every sector can get behind. And I also want to set up some social capital pots that MPs themselves can administer. You guys are best placed in your communities to spot those gaps and spot the opportunities, and I want to give you more agency to serve your communities. And finally, I want all of our citizens to be able to live in safety and security. I'm committing to our manifesto commitment on defence spending and our NATO spending pledge. But I am also going to remove some of the strains on our armed forces and take tasks from them that they don't need to do. And so I'm going to stand up a civil defence force, as I outlined when I rewrote this country's resilience strategy. And I want us to consolidate and capitalise on the huge amount of civic action there was during the pandemic. All those volunteers that came forward to make our country the most resilient nation on earth. My country and our party has been through a lot in the last few years. But we have stamina. Make no mistake about that. In that moment of crisis during the pandemic, the British public stepped forward. They were moved by the values of this country too. They are capable and responsible people. They expect their government to be too. Yes. They expect us to deliver on both the mandate and the majority they handed us. I can, and we will.
Thank you so much, Penny. Now, unusually, Penny is determined to answer a number of questions. So, the ladies and gentlemen of the press, hold on to your hats. But I'm first of all going to take a question from the gentleman here. Thank you.
You've made a very attractive child care policy announcement. Can you be more specific about what it means for parents?
It's the same amount of money, but we're going to stop telling parents how they have to spend it. What it will mean is, it will be completely flexible. It will be able to be used to be tailored to what that family needs. And we don't have to spend more money to deliver some of these services better. We just have to do them in a smarter way.
Great. Beth Rigby, Sky.
Thank you. Penny Morden, you have a big unknown in this contest. You were never a Johnson supporter. You were never part of his reshuffled cabinet team running the country over the past couple of years. The public have no idea who you are, and neither do lots of us either. What one diarist described you as Theresa May with bigger hair. And if you win this election, will you, like May, call another general election to get your mandate rather than riding on the coattails of Boris Johnson?
I was a candidate at the last general election. I stood on the same platform as these good people in front of me. And I think what the public want us to do is deliver on that now. Yeah. Yeah. I would like to know you all better, and I hope I will get the opportunity to. Yeah. I stood on the same platform as Boris Johnson and every single Member of Parliament in my party. We have a mandate and we have a big majority, and I think the British people want us to get on and deliver. I'm not going to talk about other candidates. They can set out their stall. But what I would say to you is, who can not just win this contest, but win a general election? Yeah. If we do not win the next general election, all those opportunities and the vision that the British people had from us leaving the European Union will not be realised. We must win that election. Yeah. I am your best shot at winning that election. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I am the candidate that Labour fear the most. Yeah, yeah, yeah. And they're right to.
majority of people listening to this morning who've not come across you before and perhaps wonder whether you have it in you to be Prime Minister in just a couple of months' time. What do you say to them?
I think that I am one of the best prepared candidates in this contest. I've served in a huge number of ministerial positions. I've also served in the private sector. I've worked in the public sector and in the charity sector. And you'll know I've thought deeply about where our country is at, who we need to compete with, and how we can put through the reforms and modernisation with our mandate, with the management in Whitehall, with the mutuality that binds us together and with our markets. We have to pick up the pace to realise the opportunities that this country has, and I am best placed to do that.
Yeah. Yes, thank you very much. Hi, Penny. We all thought you were a fantastic Defence Secretary. How do you think your experience in the armed forces will be an asset for you going forward to be the next Prime Minister?
Well, I open my campaign by talking about teamwork. I think we've had a failed model of leadership, and that's part of the problem why government hasn't been as effective as it could be. I know from my naval training that it's about harnessing the power of the team, and that is how I'm going to govern.
Hi, Penny. Some of your rivals want a war on woke and for wedge issues to be a key part of mobilising Conservative voters in the run-up to the next general election. If you're Prime Minister, will you throw them the red meat they want?
Well, I think we should be talking about cost of living. I think we should talk about healthcare. But let me deal with the issue that is floating in the background there. I think it was Margaret Thatcher that said that every Prime Minister needs a willy. A woman like me doesn't have one. Well, they're very sensible people because I am a threat to their campaigns. But what I'm going to be talking about in this campaign, I said to my campaign team on our first meeting, we are going to campaign as we would govern, and the only people I am going to take the fight to is our opposition. I am very different to Boris Johnson, but we're still on the same manifesto, and I think we believe in those same things. We both were passionate about the opportunity that Britain leaving the regulatory orbit of the EU was, not just to our country, but to the world. And I understand that very well, and I am determined to capitalise on that.
Was he a good Prime Minister?
I think we should thank him for delivering Brexit. It was an incredibly difficult thing to do, as we all remember, and I think we should remember him for that.
Chris Hope, last question.
Penny, last one, a quick one and a straightforward one. How do you define a woman?
I'm a woman. I am biologically a woman. And I can tell you, Chris, that if you have been in the Royal Navy and you have competed physically against men, you understand the biological difference between men and women. Yeah. Thank you all so much. Thank you for coming. Thanks. Let's win this campaign.